Move forward. All right, good. How's everybody doing here? Good. Tim Dry, turn on your video. Jeff Engelbrecht, turn on your video.
Sorry, I'm having camera issues again.
Okay, bye. Get a good camera. Get a good five. Get an iPhone.
I know. I need to get on it.
Get good equipment. Don't get shit equipment. That's your mantra. Somebody get a tattoo today and says, Claude said, don't buy shit equipment.
Can it be temporary?
Okay, good. What are we? I'm happy today. Are you guys happy? Von Cross, are you happy while you're building something there? What do you got, a drill? Or you're
building, doing some stairs up here in, where am I? Carlsbad?
Oh, not Carlsbad, California or New Mexico?
Yes, sir. Yeah, I'm a San Diego boy.
Oh, so am I.
I got these nice fluted posts here.
Yeah, Rancho Santa Fe.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm right near you. I have Solana Beach area.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it's beautiful. real nice area there. I thought you reminded me of my dentist.
Yeah.
And everything. Are you happy today? Are you doing what you love?
Absolutely. I'm very happy today.
All right, good. Good. Is that your house you're working on, or you're in a construction business?
No, I'm a carpenter. I'm in construction.
Nice going, man.
Yeah,
nice
thank going. You.
The trade, a lot of people I tell go into the trades, right?
Yeah, well, it's booming down here right now. You know, a lot of people are remodeling and,
Good times or bad, a good carpenter, plumber, electrician, can they always make money? Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Good. Alex Gillian, are you happy today?
Yeah, happy to be here, Claude.
Good. Why?
A good day.
Why is it a good day? I'm not going to let you get off easy.
Yeah, learning how to use guts.
There you go. There you go. Jerry Smith, turn on that video. Show us that handsome face. Alex Bolden, come on in. There he is. You happy today, Jerry? You're smiling.
Very happy.
Why? And remember, this is a family show.
Spending a lot of money on my house.
Spending money. That's interesting. You're happy spending money.
My wife is happy.
All right. Happy wife, happy life, man.
All right.
How long you been married?
8 years.
Oh, that's nothing. You're on a honeymoon still. I've been married 35 years.
Okay.
There you go. The new guy on the block. Go ahead, Jerry.
It just keeps getting better.
Amen, brother. Thank you. That's great. Davis, yes. the new guy, introduce yourself.
Yeah, hey, what's up, family? My name is Davis. I live in Houston, Texas. I literally just connected with Claude yesterday, so it's good to meet you all. I'm happy today because I get to learn from all your experiences, and I get to learn from Claude. Specifically, I'm in real estate, so I do a little bit of real estate investing, and I'm going to do a little bit of consulting, so I'm looking forward to getting
just a little. Just a little bit?
Just a little bit of what?
Consult. You said, I'm going to do just a little bit of consulting.
No, I'm going to do some crazy consulting. I'm going to
do a shitload of consulting. We're going to talk about that today. You know what's the problem with this business? No, Claude, what's the problem with this business? It's feast and famine. Okay. 1 minute we're rich. We did a deal. Next month, nothing. All of a sudden, get that nervous feeling in the pit of your stomach again, right? Anybody else besides me experience that? Consulting fills in the gaps, but very few people do it. And that's the problem. So if I, Mr. Alex Bolden, how are you, sir?
I'm good.
Are you happy?
Yes, I am.
Okay, good. We're going to do a role play. I'll tell you guys why I'm happy today. It's only Wednesday, and I did two deals this week already. Two really nice deals. Sometimes it's feast or famine, isn't it? It's just funny. All that hard work, all once in a while, the forces of the universe work in your favor. And so we did two deals. This were, you want to have a 35 year old, you want to have a happy marriage? Is everybody ready? Get your pen and paper out. I'm going to give you guys the secret of having the best relationship of your life. Everybody ready? Everybody got a pen out? Alex, you know what I'm going to say. I know you know. Okay, you want to have a great relationship? Here you go. Make a shitload of money. Okay.
You're not better once the money is rolling in.
Now, I know some of you said that sounds horrible, Claude. A meaningful relationship should not be based on monetary experiences and yada, yada, right? I'm going to tell you right now, when you got a problem, when the refrigerator breaks, you need a new washing machine, you need a new car, and you know what? You just say, honey, money's there, get whatever you need. Everything, it reduces the stress in a relationship. Is money a big problem in relationships? Tell the truth, roll on two martinis and sodium pentothal. I gave you all a shot here, right through Zoom. It's one of those new additions they have here. Yeah, make a lot of money. The way you make a lot of money is make a lot of phone calls, use the guts method, asking questions. Do not give logical, premature presentations, okay? And make sure you ask a lot of questions to get the prospect upfront emotionally involved. Even ask the opposite expected questions and direction. Let's do a role play here. Alex, ring, ring. Where's my phone? Ring, ring.
Who is this?
Is that the way you answer the phone? Give me a break. You're a businessman. I'm not going to let you get away with that. Sorry. Ring, ring.
Hello?
No. Would someone show him how to answer the phone like a businessman? Who's going to do that for me?
I am the buyer. You were being a buyer.
You can be. Don't worry about the role just yet. The role will come. I want you to answer. How do you answer the phone as a businessman? Ring, ring.
Hello, good evening. This is Alex. How can I help you?
Okay. Your company doesn't have a business? A name?
Not the real estate company. I didn't form an LLC for the real estate stuff yet.
Okay. And when you answer the phone, answer like you're a very busy business person. Okay. Somebody give me a ring. Somebody give me a ring, ring.
Ring, ring.
Diamond Consulting Group. This is Claude. How may I help you? That's
what. Hey, this is. Oh, okay. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, Claude Diamond here. I saw your webpage and I got a bunch of questions to ask you about lease purchase real and wholesaling real estate. Can you help me? I heard a great, I loved your webpage, man. You're great.
I probably can. What are you looking for, Claude? Are you looking to get into lease purchasing?
I'm looking to get in. I got my grandma's home down in Orlando. And I'm thinking of doing something with it. It's free and clear. It's out of probate. And I'm thinking of either renting it, rent to own it, or just, I don't know what I want to do. And I wanted to speak. I loved your webpage. Someone told me to give you a call. I saw some of your YouTube videos. You're doing YouTube videos, right, Alex?
I haven't been doing my YouTube videos.
Okay. Why do I say off the role play? Why am I saying that?
Marketing, because that's how you get the leads coming in.
Early to bed, early to rise, work like hell and advertise. And advertising is expensive. True or false? True.
It's very expensive.
Okay, and pay per click.
I would know that more than anyone.
Okay, I'm gonna get opinionated. Somebody can disagree with me. Pay per click is a waste of money. Oh, geez, he's got an opinion. Oh no. Okay, we're scared to have opinions today, right?
Yeah, we're not allowed to.
You're not allowed to have opinions. Oh, you're hurting my feelings. Oh, God. Oh, he had a friggin' opinion. You're allowed to have opinions. Okay.
Right.
You're allowed freedom of speech and everything. You don't want to intentionally hurt anybody. You got to be reasonable, but you're allowed to. Marketing, we waste more money. I've been mentoring and teaching people for a long time, over 30 years, and more people go broke before their business ever gets started, wasting money on marketing. True or false?
Yeah. It is true.
Anybody have an opinion?
That's true.
Yeah.
It's definitely true.
What I do is I do a lot, just to where we were going from before. I'm not picking on you, Alex. You know I love you.
I'm not picking on
you. YouTube videos, you do all these little 1 minute video shorts or a 3 minute video. Talk about a mistake. Talk about a success story. Talk about something you learned today. I learn things every day. I read books. I watch podcasts. I learn something every day. Talk about something, you know, just be yourself, be comfortable, and put out those videos, TikTok, Instagram. I think you can, Twitter, can you, Facebook, you can do shorts now, I believe. Someone help me. Who's a marketing expert in the room here? Can we do video shorts on Facebook?
You could do shorts on Facebook as well.
These little video shorts, if you have a good title, you have good content, you're not reading a script, you're just relaxed, you're just sharing good information, telling stories, maybe even being entertaining. Guess what happens? You get free leads. I run my whole business on free leads. People call me from all over the world, not just the US, okay? I get phone calls from all over the world because I do YouTube videos. And then I share the YouTube videos into Instagram and Reddit and you name it, Facebook, Twitter, all those places. And I always put an incentive at the end. Hi, give me a call. Hi, go to my webpage, get a free mind map on lease purchasing, on wholesale real estate, on gut sales. Hi, schedule 15 minutes with me and pick my brain. Guess what? Get two or three major benefits when you put out content marketing. Guess what they are?
Just a ton of free leads.
Ton of free leads, and people are calling and contacting you. Is there a better lead than a warm lead?
No,
not at all.
Or you can do what a lot of other people do. I don't do that. They buy lists. They scrape lists. They buy systems. Okay, and you're calling up these poor these people who have no idea who you are, based on a computer algorithm. Okay, on some mathematical formulation. They were in foreclosure. They're behind in their taxes. They are an absentee owner or something like that. Okay, those are computer generated. But when you call that person, what's the mathematical likelihood that they're going to want to speak to you? It's very little. It's usually less than 1%, if truth be told. When I do attraction marketing and Joe Blow calls me up today, schedules with me, sends me a text or an email, is that a warm lead? Is that a good starting place?
Yes.
You better believe it. Now, I don't know if Joe Blow has money, has a problem, has authority to make a commitment. Is it timely? Has the character to keep a commitment? But if I speak to enough Joe or Joanne Blows every day because they came to me, those are good phone calls. I'm sorry, I'm going on a tangent here. We were doing a nice role play there, but that's the way I roll. Sorry. But I like to share the things that work for me. Okay. All I want, I only have one goal, is to see other people make a lot of money and not make the mistakes I made. My whole purpose of mentoring, I do a lot of mentoring, claudediamond.com. If some of you never heard of me, go to my webpage. I always have free stuff there. My whole goal is to teach people all the stupid things I did, like spend too much money on marketing, knock on a lot of doors of people who don't want to see me, read scripts. I don't want you to do the mistakes I made. I want you to do the smart things I do. My wife and I run a multi-million dollar business. We're debt-free, mortgage-free. We could retire very comfortably if I wanted to. I don't want to. I love what I do. So this is the whole point of it, of where I share so much stuff. And I try to speak emphatically about it. Feel free to ask questions, by the way, if you have any questions, because I get on a soapbox. Sharonda knows I get on a roll. Watch out, right?
No, you do a great job. Thank you.
Thank you. I didn't need a compliment.
We love having you on, Claude.
So back in there. Alex, you're back in the role play here. Alex, I saw your YouTube video. That's where we started 15 minutes ago, right?
Right over.
Right. And yeah, you're great. I just want to pick your brain, man.
Well, thanks for checking me out, Claude. I am a bit busy, but I'm just curious. Are you looking to do a JV deal with your grandmother's house?
Or I don't know. What's JV? I'm new, man. I sell used Q-tips. Ugh. Oh, wait. Let me think. I'm a Chihuahua trainer, okay? A Chihuahua dog walker, okay?
Okay, I don't know how I would do it. Picture.
Yeah, I don't know anything. What's JMV? By the way, off the role play. When you go to somebody and you use these words, JV, all these other words or letters or things. I learned last week what LOL means. Okay, I'm slow. No, I knew what it meant. But the thing is, if somebody is new to the business, do you think they're going to know what JV means, seriously?
Absolutely not. You're right.
Okay. And what do they do if they're embarrassed? They don't want to appear stupid. What's human nature?
They disagree.
They will just, JV, you know? Oh, sure, you know.
They will either agree or just say no.
If they agree, but they don't understand what you're talking about, does that put it in the right environment for you, Alex?
No, not at all.
No, man. No. So be careful. I'm sorry. I'm jumping all over you today. Should I pick on somebody else, or are you still up for it?
Oh, we can keep going.
Oh, good. Good man. You made a good start.
All right. So
yeah, JV, joint venture. I don't even know what joint venture is or
anything. So that means like we will partner together on a deal. So are you looking for a partner or a coach?
I don't know. You know, I just want to ask you a bunch of questions. I got grandma's property in Orlando. I think it's worth about $525,000. That's what somebody told me, and one of the neighbors. It's a really cute little 3-bedroom, two and a half bath house. And I'm thinking of renting it or renting to own it. And I just need some, I probably need some handhold, like a rent to own. You don't have any sample contracts you could show me, would you?
Oh, well, Claude, to get that, I can offer you some coaching to do that. I mean, do you want to coach? I can teach you how to.
Too fast. You're kissing me at the doorstep and you haven't bought me a drink yet.
Okay.
This is a bad visual, okay? slow down. This is important. Sales is the art and science of seduction.
Okay.
Did I say that sexy, Kayella? Did I say that right?
My name, yeah.
Did I say your name right, Kayella?
You did.
Sales is the art and science of the seduction. And I don't mean that nasty. I mean getting someone to like and trust you. Okay. So if Alex goes right in there, oh, I'm going to coach you and you're going to give me a sack full of money. Is that moving a little too fast?
Yeah, maybe so.
Yeah.
Maybe if I were to ask, would he be open to receiving some coaching?
Nurture me first. Make me fall in love with you. I'm very romantic today. I'm sorry, ladies. I can't help it. It must be something in my Lime Perrier here or something, or the pumpkins behind me. Slowly. See, you're...
What happened? This is the part I'm not good at. I'm so straightforward when it comes to guts.
when you met your beautiful wife, you've been married for how long?
A little over 2 years.
2 years. First date. You just grabbed her and kissed her the minute you saw, right?
I think that was the second date.
That was the second date. Wait for the second date. There you go. Right. Sharonda, you're laughing a little too hard at that.
It was just funny.
Yeah, I'm a bit aggressive.
This is not the Ron LeGrand show, I'm telling you right now. Or Robert Kiyosaki. I like to have a lot of fun while we're learning. And the thing about it is slowly, very slowly, good things come slowly sometimes. You want to nurture me along. Like, Claude, you're looking to make some money on the house. It's a great questions you've done. Give me a stroke. You know, these are great questions. You're really doing your homework. What's your primary? Ask me a question like a doctor. What's your goal here? To make money, to get the property on automatic? Could you help me if you're on video, say this. Always say this. Here's a real big tip of the day. If you're on video, you say, you mind if I write down some of this? This is really good stuff you're sharing with me. You know, what happens when you tell people you're going to write down some notes? What happens to them? Well, what are you doing?
That makes them like you because they know that you are listening to them.
Yeah. That's a stroke, a subliminal stroke. Isn't sales, how do you blow away your competition? You blow away your competition by getting a prospect to say, I don't care if he's a new guy, if he's just starting out, if he doesn't have a big fancy office or anything, I just like and trust this person. So number one, and this is scientific. This is from the science of the psychology of persuasion, Robert Cialdini, who I always cite on there. Liking and trust. You get someone to like you, the door is wide open for a discussion, asking questions, getting them emotionally involved, and then giving the presentation.
You can even make mistakes and still do the deal.
Right. It's a seduction. It's got to be slow. So let's slow it down a little. You got to buy me a drink or two first. Okay.
Go for it.
Okay. I'm real happy. Give me one or two drinks. I'm a happy guy. So Alex, I'm calling. I don't know what to do. It's grandma's home. It's worth about $525. I'm in Pinehurst, North Carolina. That's where I really am. Grandma's home, it just settled in the probate. And so what would you do if you were in my position?
Well, Claude, well, that's a great question, Claude. Well, what's your end goal? Are you looking to make some passive income here?
Passive income, is that monthly income? I'm not sure.
Yeah, that's monthly income, or are you looking to get a lot of cash up front?
You know, I have two kids, they're in high school, and they're both, one's going to law school, and my daughter's going to medical school, but that's in a year from now. Okay. So I'm thinking a passive income. I'd have to pay taxes if I got a big bunch of income, right?
You would definitely have to pay some taxes if you got a lump sum.
Oh God, you're so smart. I'm so glad I'm talking with you. Oh my gosh. In passive income, I think, does that mean monthly or something?
Yeah, that means monthly.
Oh, thank you. Okay, I didn't know that. Yeah, I would like to have that monthly income and then I could save that money, but I don't want to be a property manager or anything like that. So that's why I'm thinking doing a rent to own or straight rental. I want the money for the kids for college.
Okay, well, Claude, I believe I can help you do that. I mean, I can help you out. Well, suppose I can help you with that. Is that something you would be open to?
Okay. Well, yeah, that's why I'm calling. I have a bunch of questions. I hope I'm not taking up too much of your time.
No, I have about 5 more minutes, Claude.
Oh, great, great. Do I need, like, if I do a rent to own, can I get money up front? I heard you can get something like option money and that passive income. I can get money every month.
Oh, yes, you can do that.
Oh, do I need a special contract or do you have any samples you could send me or something like that?
I don't have any samples that I give out,
Hold on, give me a cookie first. Keep giving me cookies. Great question. These are, you've really done your homework. You're sure this is your first deal?
Okay.
Why you stroke me sincerely? Why?
To gain the guy's trust.
Mm-hmm.
I like to get straight to the point.
Yeah. Well, what happens? Yeah, but he called you. Remember, the prospect came to you. You're right. Not cold calling. So that might be a different thing if you were cold calling. Then you'd have to do pattern interrupts. Somebody remind me to do pattern interrupts on a cold call. Okay, we'll do some of that too. But this is part, don't you want to get me so emotionally involved? What emotions are we trying to develop here while we're having this nice adult to adult conversation?
Trust.
Need.
Likeability.
Yeah, we were talking a little bit about money. Should Alex maybe say, you know, I know Orlando. I think you can get about $2,500, maybe $3,000 a month for a nice home. Do you think he could hit my greed button? Is greed an emotion?
Yes, it is.
What starts happening when you start putting in my head $36,000 a year coming in automatically? Mm-hmm. Did you just put a value on your possible service?
Oh yeah.
Ooh, you like Alan Bryan? Alan Bryan likes that. Alan Bryan said, "Okay, gave me the okay." it's important. You got to get me. See, if you just go right ahead, do you ever walk into a car dealership? Would you ever get trapped by an Amway salesperson at a party or something? Oh, you got to buy this shampoo. It's only $38 a bottle. You know, well, I get Pert from Walmart, a big bottle for $8. Boom, you're trapped, right? Yeah. Nobody wants to be trapped and sold, do they?
Nope.
Everybody shake your heads no. Nobody wants to try, but we love to buy. Tommy Hopkins said that people don't want to be sold, but they love to buy. Yep. When they meet somebody they like and trust, and they see, this is the biggie, you know, they see the value. So now you have to create a value in me. Talk about the money I could make. You said you're busy. I love that. Keep saying, oh, I'm so busy. I've got so many deals. That's also social proof. When you tell me right. you're busy, when you tell me you're busy, what are you saying to me? What is going, what do you think is going through my head when you keep saying, I got to get off the phone. I'm so busy.
Yeah, this guy must be making a lot of money and doing a lot of deals.
You're a smart young man. Your mom did good with you. Okay, exactly. And you develop that. Then you say, Claude, you know what? I've made it. Oh, this is one of my best closing. You guys want my $1 million closing line? You get your pens ready. Get your pens ready. You ready? $1 million closing line. Alex, I've made, reversing the role. Alex, I've made a decision.
You made a decision. Are you talking about, Claude?
I'm talking about helping you to make you sound like a good man, a good family man, a good father. You got two great kids. You want to help them through college, dental school, law school, and everything. I've made a decision. I'm going to help you to get the money so you can put your kids through college. I'm going to help you with grandma's home if you want my services today. Or you could just say no to me. But I've made that decision. For you to make that $36,000 a year, $3,000 a month, and set up your property properly. How do you feel about that?
I feel great. Well, I know it's going to cost me, Claude, so.
It's going to cost you. Is it worth spending X amount of dollars? Now, how much should you, okay, someone take over. Sharonda, take over my position now. Close on Alex now. You got to make a consulting fee, Sharonda.
Okay, so yeah, I would love to help you with getting the money that you need to help your children through school. I just need to set up an arrangement with you so you can compensate me for my services.
End in a question.
Oh, okay.
End in a question.
How does that sound to you?
It sounds good. Well, how much is it?
Well, it's not much. Let's see. You're looking to get $3,000 a month, right?
Yes.
Okay. So I would just be taking a one-time fee. It wouldn't be much at all. Would you like to move forward today? Can I send the contract over?
Absolutely. How much is it going to cost?
Tell them.
Well, for you, because I really did enjoy speaking with you and I understand your situation, I would just be asking for $7,500. That would be the fee. Are you willing to?
Can you do $4,000?
Well, I do have a lot of other people that I have to speak with as well. But I can work with you for $5,000. Is that something that's more comfortable for you?
Well, I don't have $5,000 on hand right now, but.
Okay, that's fine. I understand that. Well, I can take a $3,000 payment today, and then I could bill you for the rest when the transaction actually goes through. How does that sound?
Yeah, that sounds fine with me.
Wonderful. I'll be sending the contract over. Thank you.
All right.
You didn't get paid.
Well, yes, you did good.
You didn't get paid. You didn't get paid, Sharonda.
But I was going to send him the contract over.
When do you get paid? Alan, come on, get in here. Alan Bryan.
Today. You get paid today.
Okay, go ahead, Claude. You know what, Alan? I like your. I. You know what? $5,000. That's fair. Tell me. Can I give you $2,500 today and $2,500 in 2 weeks?
Claude, I mean, I don't usually do this, but I really like talking to you. But suppose I was able to do that today for you. What would you want to do next?
Send me over the contract. That's great. Send me over your contract.
Would you be able to pay me the $2,500 right now, or probably not?
Oh, you need it right now.
Yeah, this. If you want to move forward at this rate that I'm giving you, we would need it right now. How would you like to pay that?
Okay, nurture a little and bring in the emotion, the EQ, the emotion. On Monday in my group call, we talked for an hour on the EQ, emotional quotient. Don't just ask for the money. Say, you know what? We've had a great conversation. You want to take care of grandma's home so you can put your kids in college. You want this to be maintenance free on automatic pilot. You need good contracts so you don't have to waste thousands of dollars on an attorney. I'm going to help you with all of these things to set up your lease purchase if you're comfortable with this. And can you, would you be able to put, could you do $2,500 today?
Gotcha. Noting.
Say something like that. Go back, bring up all the needs and greeds. Keep it emotional. People make decisions emotionally. Keep me in that emotional state, because if you get too pragmatic, too technical, you're losing that emotional momentum you've had.
All right. Thanks for the feedback. All right. Claude, I understand that, you know, you're a good father. You want to provide for your family, for their college expenses. And, you know, you don't have a lot of time on your hand, and you'd rather be spending that quality time with your family. So you kind of want things on autopilot, if I'm not mistaken, correct?
Yeah.
And, you know,
yeah, it all makes sense what you said. I really appreciate your time. I know how busy you are. Thank you. Yeah, this sounds great. Send me over the contract.
Great. And Claude, I want to get this started for you so that you can go on your merry way and do what you have to do for your family. You wouldn't be able to get this started today and some money today, would you?
How do you do that? I'm sorry. What
great. I can take Visa, MasterCard, Amex. What do you have?
Pick one.
We'll do the Visa one.
Okay. Here you go. Are you ready? Wait.
Yeah, yes.
Hold on. Here's a big problem. Everybody does. I do it too. Accept yes as an answer.
Okay.
Did I just say yes? Did I hold up the cards?
Yes.
And what did you, and what's the next thing you should say?
What's the number?
I have a pen. Go ahead.
Go ahead. I have a pen, Claude. Shoot me the number over.
Boom. That was the difference between what Sharonda did and what you did. You got $2,500 now. Sharonda, you send him the contract. He's got to go and take the kids to Chuck E. Cheese Pizza Parlor. He gets called away from work the next day. He has to travel. He forgets about you. Cousin Larry calls him up and says, don't give that person money. I'll help you with it instead. Cousin Larry's, you know, everybody's cousin who has, he knows everything, but he drives a 40-year-old car, okay, a rust bucket. What can happen in time, Sharonda?
So I was supposed to get that commitment right then.
Right now.
Okay.
When do you kiss that good-looking boy on a nice date, on a good date?
Oh my, right then.
Okay. There we go. So sometimes you got to go for it. Okay. And when you have that momentum and you're on that honeymoon period with the prospect, go for it. That's the time to pull the trigger and get paid. Get the commitment, get paid. If you delay it because, well, I don't want to rock the boat and tell him I'm too pushy or anything, what happens when he gets the contract that evening, but he gets distracted or busy, or the momentum is gone?
He's going to change his mind. He may change his mind.
This is how dangerous sales is. Everybody write this down. Sales is dangerous. It's so scary dangerous. Because in one moment you could make $2,500, $25,000. You could get a commitment. You could get everything. And if you delay it because you're not willing to utilize everything you worked for, all that stroking, all that nurturing, all those questions, if you're not willing to pull the trigger on that magic moment, the forces of the universe start to work against you.
That makes sense.
Isn't sales scary as hell?
It is. It's, you got to be assertive, it sounds like.
Oh, I got to tell my one story. I've told this one before so many times. We had a property going back 20-something years. Had a beautiful home in Southern California. Oh, it was 2008 or something. We couldn't move it. It was dead. Business was just dead. And this property was costing us a lot of money every month. And I was talking about a happy marriage before. Okay. Mrs. Diamond does not like it when we're writing checks month after month on an empty property. This is not how to succeed in business. Okay, so I needed to get this property moved. I didn't even want option money anymore. I didn't want a lot of option money. In the beginning, I wanted $10,000, and then I dropped it to five, then 20. At that moment, I had one lady call, come to the property. I would have done it for $1,000. Okay, $1,000 option money. And I was just ready to say it. Do you ever have something on the tip of your tongue? You're ready to spit it out. And the lady beat me to it. She said, Claude, the most I can give you is $8,500. Do you know how scary it is to lose almost $7,500 because you opened your mouth? Has anyone got a story or something like that where you were just ready to open your mouth and you think you opened it up prematurely? Anybody?
No.
No?
But that was a great story, though. I'm going to keep that in my mind for the future.
It was so scary. To imagine losing $7,500 when you really need it. And that was 20 years ago. That 75 was worth a lot more then. Okay, a lot more. Just because you almost opened your mouth. So who should talk first in negotiation? Who should be the first to mention price? This is hard. This is a real difficult part. What do you think?
Whoever wants to lose.
Well, yeah, you know, the old rule is the first to mention price always loses, right? Have we all heard that?
Yep.
But what happens if we go, we go back and forth and back and forth? Hey Davis, what's your best price for my home?
I can do 400,000 for you.
Now you ask me, what's your best offer? Let's go back and forth a little bit. Nobody wants to say the price first.
Right.
What's your best price for that home, Davis? I'm really interested.
Best price I can do is about, oh, okay. Don't answer. Okay.
Go back and forth. Well, the price is, it's what's listed. You know, you saw the listing.
Okay. Am I supposed to respond to that?
Yeah, we're role playing.
Okay.
This is how I teach. You're the new guy. That's not fair. I go into spontaneous role plays with people.
Okay.
and this is my teaching technique, because to me, the money's made in the dialogue with people. True or false? Mm-hmm. I think you could do all the VAs. You could do all the emails and texting. You could do all the ads on Facebook and everything. But where is the money made?
Conversation.
In the conversation. Never forget that. And that's why my rule of five, if you can speak to a handful, five people or more a day, and you make offers every day, and you ask a lot of questions every day with that stroking and nurturing blended in, you cannot help but make more money than you'll ever need in life. Mm. It's hard. It takes time to learn it. It's not get rich quick. It is get wealthy slowly. But if you learn these skills, this is my superpower. The only thing I got going for me is a big mouth. But I learned from my mentor is if you ask the right questions and use your words the right way, you ask the right sentence, use the right sentences and questions, and you use a system, the three steps, you get a lot of better conversations rather than that rejection all day long. Absolutely. Let's go back and forth. So what's the best price you can give me, Davis?
What's the price that you see online?
It's 450, but you can do better than that, can't you?
Well, what is it that you're trying to pay?
The best price you can give me.
Well, the best price I can give you is what's listed on there.
Okay, so what's going on? Are we coming together or falling apart?
Seems like we're falling apart.
We're falling apart, right? Mm-hmm. We're butting heads, right?
Yeah.
You know, we're two mm-hmm. two mountain sheep butting heads to each other. I see these that we have these giant mountain goats in Colorado, where another place I live, and they smash right into each other to exert dominance over the herd. So we go back and forth and we fall apart and it's getting nasty now, snippy. Okay. So somebody sooner or later, so the rule is go once around on the price. If you can avoid mentioning the price, because like that lady who I would have taken $1,000, she offered $8,500. So it's good to have the first mentioned price. But if it goes around more than once, then someone's got to give a price. So if you're the buyer on the property, I'm probably going to say to you, well, you have a $200,000 mortgage. I know your property has been sitting empty for 6 months. Could you do it for $315? And then you come back with another number, right? Mm-hmm. And we negotiate. Go ahead. Can you do $315, Davis?
Well, $315 sounds like a reasonable.
Really?
Sounds.
You know what I'm thinking? Shit, I should have said $295. What? Isn't that human nature? Seriously, when you make an offer and someone agrees readily, what's the first thing that goes in your mind?
Gotta go lower.
I should have got more, right?
Oh yeah.
Alex Gullion, it sounds like you were nodding your head there and smiling. Is this something that occurs in your world?
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah. It does. So it's kind of the negotiation is pretty interesting, isn't it? So you don't, one party, the devil on your shoulder says, you know, go ahead, ask for everything. And the angel saying, no, you'll insult her. You're asking too much. So you got to take chances. Sales is dangerous, isn't it? Who wants to do a role? Anybody have a role play? I've been suggesting all the role plays today. Anybody ever get a stall or an objection? What's the stall and objections we hear out there? And here's a rule. Go ahead, Sharonda.
So I guess it's a little bit of a story as well. I was trying to put together a deal last week. And so the price point was a little bit higher than what I'm used to dealing with. The property's worth $700,000. And I was trying to put it together. So the ARV was $700,000, but I wanted to offer the seller $500,000. So that it would have worked for me if he would have taken $500,000, but he wanted $590,000. So I was trying to talk him down. I would have went to $515,000, but he didn't even want to go that low. So it ended up not working out. But I've been in a situation like that. It didn't quite work out.
Okay. How did you base your $500,000 offer?
I went to the property and I took pictures and estimated the damages and made sure I had an accurate ARV. And in order for me to be able to put the deal together and get the funding and to get my fee, my assignment fee, it had to be at $500,000.
Okay, it's a big gap between 700 to 500. I was just wondering. One of the ways I determine what my offer price will be is based on first research. What's their mortgage? Someone tells me they got a property with a $700,000 property with a $250 mortgage. There's a lot of icing on the cake there. There's a lot of room there. The next thing I'm going to ask is, are they occupied? Is the property, are they living in the property or is it vacant or is it an investment rental property? Why? You know why I do that? I want to know their EQ, their how much emotion, how much pain they're in. Okay. If yeah, they're in a rental property. Say again.
It was a rental property and they were like thousands of dollars behind. So they needed to get rid of the property quickly.
Okay, good. That means they were at least a 7 or an 8, at least, right?
Absolutely.
Well, we love that. And what your job is to do is become the Marquis de Sade, inflict greater pain on them. Okay. You want to inflict, because the more pain they're in, do you ever start out with something and you had a price in your head and then the pain and the anxiety and just the all the work and you said, oh, you know what? I'm going to drop my price and you drop it and you drop it again. Do you ever lower your price as the anxiety, as something got more and more difficult and uncomfortable? Isn't that human nature?
Absolutely.
Yeah. On that. So your job when you're speaking to somebody is to maybe go in the opposite direction. Sharonda, why don't you just fix up the house yourself, rent it out again? It sounds like a great investment property. Why, you sure you want to sell it?
Yes, I need to sell it because I'm already underwater with it, and I can't afford to carry the payments anymore.
Oh,
so
I'm okay.
Going to evict the tenants and sell it.
Oh, okay. I understand. Why don't you refinance it? Sounds you probably have a ton of equity in it, right?
There's no equity.
Oh, there's no equity. So it's a $700,000 property and it's fully mortgaged.
Yes.
Big problem. Okay, off the role play. Is that a property fully mortgaged, problem property? It needs repairs. What's our next strategy if we were faced with that kind of deal?
I wanted to lease. I would want to lease option it if they were open to it.
How are you going to lease it? It's behind in payments. Like you in the, I'm just going from the role play here. It was behind in payments, I thought I heard you say.
It is.
So that means you've got to make up 3 to 6 months payments. So you got to put cash in. Does it need repairs? Maybe. You just got to put more cash in. You got to evict the tenant. Is this going to be worth all this time, trouble, and investment for a property that's it has no equity or anything like that?
It might not be worth the headache.
It's not mine. So what's the next strategic move you do, Davis? This is like class. If you're watching Netflix during my show, you're in trouble, right?
Honestly, I'm not sure.
You got a deal. You can't do the deal. It's no deal there, but you got someone with a nine, who's an 8, 9, or 10 in terms of pain.
I'm not sure.
Come on. This is the subject you and I talked about. This is what my mentor was great at, turning chicken shit into chicken salad.
Are you talking about, no way, no.
Yeah, we are, the big C. When you can't do the deal, question for the group. When you can't do the deal, the numbers don't make sense, the repairs, the back payments, it's just the numbers just are not there for you, and the location is bad, and everything, and there's a tenant in there and all the other stuff. What's the next best thing to do? Why are we in business, ladies and gentlemen?
Make money today.
Amen, brother. Make money today.
Consult.
Yeah. Consult with me.
Right.
Yeah. Go ahead. Go ahead. Put me in pain. I'm in pain. Yeah, I got this property, Davis. And I just want to get out of it. I got a bad tenant in it. I'm 6 months behind in payments. I don't know what to do, man. I need help.
Well, I think in this situation, what I can do is I do want to help you today. And I do have a service that can help you in that. And that'll be a consulting. So is that something that you'd be?
Slow down. Give me a cookie first. Nurture me a little. You guys are so hungry to make money. It made you into sales monsters here. Slow it down. It's a seduction, a little bit of seduction. So, you know, you got big problems, Claude. We all make mistakes. I've made mistakes, but I've made a decision. I want to help you here. Or we can get off the phone. Use scarcity, use social proof, use likability and trust. Nurture me a little. Give me a cookie. Okay. Chris Rock always said that. What do you want? Give him a cookie? You know, and then you slide right into your consultative mode, and you're going to make money today. How cool is it to make money on a Wednesday afternoon just talking to somebody? Tell me how cool that is.
That's awesome.
It feels so good. You go out shopping, you spend $200, you fill up the car, you get your Verizon bill, but you made $500 talking to somebody. Is there anything wrong with that? We're talking to people all day long anyway, right? Go ahead, make some money off me, Davis.
Okay, Claude. Well, I know that you're in a dire situation. And
my wife can't sleep at night, and it's getting tough, man. I'm using a lot of hair dye to cover all the white up here, you know?
Yeah, well, I know this is probably a problem that you've had on for some time, and I have made a decision. I would like to help you.
off the role play. Don't we love this guy now? He said, I want to help you. What happens when another person is in pain or needs help and that person says, you know what, I'm going to help. I've made a decision. I'm going to help you. What just happened to the whole environment, the whole atmosphere?
Changes.
Yeah.
Feel safe.
Yeah. We created, what's the word, the millennials? We created a little safe zone. I'm sorry, I'm nasty today. We created a nice environment. I'll use those words. Yeah. Okay, now close me. Go ahead.
Well, as far as that, is that something that you'd be interested in?
I need some help, man. I mean, it's getting scary. I need some help. I really appreciate, you know, what do you think what would you do in this situation, you know?
Well, in this situation first, as far as giving you the help, I can consult for you, so I can alleviate this problem. What I'd like to do for you is...
Be careful. You said you can alleviate this problem?
Okay.
What if we can't? Here's a rule. Law school one-on-one. Don't make promises you can't keep. Use different I'll use my best abilities. I'll call my mentor Claude. I'll ask Sharonda. I'll ask Alex Gullion. I'll talk to a lot of people. I'll do some research and we'll have meetings. And my goal is to help you. I can't guarantee it. Be careful with your words. Because they'll come back to haunt you. Davis, you took my money and you told me you were gonna help me and Man, it's worse now.
What about in that case? What if, you know, obviously as a consulting fee, you do take their money and you can't solve the problem at the end of the day?
Oh.
Okay.
You got a leaky bag of shit here, Mr. Prospect. This is the problem. These are the things you didn't tell me. This is the information I just gleaned and found. This is how we're going to have to do, sir. There's no perfect answer. We're going to have to mitigate the damage. We're going to have to, you know what we need to do? We need to call your bank. We have to see if we can, a deed in lieu of foreclosure. Can we surrender the property to the bank so that they don't have to spend a lot of money and maybe they don't put as nasty a stuff on our credit report? Can we negotiate with the bank and see if we can resolve this amicably and mitigate the damage? Something like that. I'm just giving you a solution off the top of my head. I had to do that once for somebody. Okay. There's always... You may not have the solution, but you may have good suggestions or good ideas. Okay. Okay. That's what a good consultant, a mentor, a coach does. Solutions are good. If you can solve the problem, God, I love when I can solve people's problems. But can you do that? Can you guarantee that? Can a doctor guarantee good health?
No.
No. Can a lawyer guarantee that someone who did something really dumb say, well, you're not going to jail? So what you use your words in the right context.
Okay.
This is a good subject. This is interesting.
I actually have a client, a potential client that was referred to me last week, and it was a forbearance. I've never really dealt with that, you know, because you know the niche that I'm in. You know, I kind of did. She was a recommendation of a family friend, and I was just, you know, I'll do my best to help her. And she's been calling me, and I returned her call. But I haven't talked to her for a few days now because I simply, honestly, I don't know exactly what to do. So probably that's something that you can help me up with later on.
I'd love to help you, Davis. You know what? I'm going to do a lot of research on this. I'm going to make a few phone calls to people who are a lot smarter than me. I'm going to do a lot of running around for you. I'm going to call up my mentor. I'm going to call up my lawyer, a friend of mine from school who's a lawyer in this area. I'm going to call up a few people and get as much information. Can you and I have another meeting later today or maybe tomorrow? Give me a little time and I'll advise you. I'll give you my personal opinion. Listen to my words. I'll give you my personal opinion. What I would do if I was in your situation. Does that make sense?
It does, yeah.
Okay. Now my time, you know, this is going to take me away from my other deals and my other businesses, but I on a 1 through 10, 10 meaning urgent, what number would you give yourself right now?
Right now I'd say nine.
Nine. Okay. Do you mind if we talk about money for a second?
Sure.
Okay. I'm going to charge you a flat fee of $2,500. That's going to be for X amount of hours of my time and research and consultation with you. And if that's okay with you, we will have several meetings here and figure out the best course for you to steer. So we can you imagine for a moment, now I off the role play, now I go into the nurturing. Can you imagine for a moment, you and I talk, I do the research, I come up with a couple really good ideas for you on how we can mitigate this so that by Christmas time, this property, this whole fiasco is off your back and you get a fresh start for 2022. How would you feel? How would you feel about that if we could just have a clean slate going into next year?
Really? Oh, you're asking relieved.
Relieved. Sometimes you got to wait for the answer, by the way. It's hard for me to do, as you know, but wait for that answer. It might be what we call a pregnant pause. It might seem like 10 minutes. It's only a few seconds. Wait for the, ask the questions. Always end in a question and ask the questions that help him to visualize in his head that peace of mind. Imagine this property is off your back. You and your wife can sleep at night. You can move forward now again. Life is good in 2022. Fresh start. None of this anxiety, problems, nasty letters or anything. I think, are we on the same page? That isn't what you're looking for, is it?
It is what I'm looking for.
I've made the decision. I'd like to move forward. Are you comfortable with my fee? Because I'm going to have to put in a lot of time and work, but imagine we could get this thing by Christmas resolved.
$2,500 sounds good.
Which means?
I'm willing to pay the $2,500 today.
Okay, I have a pen. Go ahead. Boom. Yeah. You just made 20. You can applaud that. That was a good role play. That was a darn good role play. 20. These things that we're doing today, this is how you go to the bank in real estate. You either do the deal or consult in the deal. I don't care what business. Are you monetizing your time, knowledge, and energy, your most natural resources? We do all. You folks are great for coming on here and joining me and role-playing and practicing and everything like that. But what we're really learning is how on a day-to-day basis we monetize our time, knowledge, and energy. This is the million-dollar skill that I always talk about. This is the missing link. All the gurus, all the firewalks, all the motivational seminars, all the stuff out there, do they talk about this stuff?
No.
No. And this is where one person who gives good phone working out of their home on a kitchen table can make all the money in the world. You're studying this stuff. You're out there. You're doing deals. You're making mistakes. We all do. And you're taking this and you're taking all this knowledge and you're monetizing it in between your deals. Is this a good subject? Absolutely. Thank you. My name is Claude Diamond, ClaudeDiamond.com. I got a webpage with my gut sales method, free consultations, free books, and feel free to go over there and get some good stuff. And you guys were great today. Thanks for all that. I put you all
thanks
on
for
today.
Thank you.
You guys are great. Thanks for joining me. Go out there, pick up the phone, talk to people. Thank you, Kiella. I'm going to get your name right. I love your name, Kiella. It's phonetically, it's easy to say. Go out there, talk to people, have fun on the phone. Don't take it too serious. Just talk to people and become their doctor and ask questions and skip the presentation and act like you're getting back to them. And they are the sick patient. They are the sick legal client. They are the ones with the problem, whether they're buying, selling, or investing, and get them talking and create that atmosphere of business so that when they get off the phone, what are they going to say? What are they going to say about you, Alex Gillian?
Yeah, that guy's a great guy. I don't mind referring some people to him.
When you get people to like and trust you because you're having these good conversations like we role play today, it makes this business so much more fun, so much more easier, and a ton more profitable. Gotta go, guys. Be good. Thanks for joining me.
Have a good day. Thank you.
Thank you.